The battle over the control of protoculture has reached beyond the limits of common sanity, as three civilizations are coming into conflict which seems to have no real direction. On one side are the Robotech Masters, displaced techno-voyagers out to reclaim their misplaced energy source. Opposing, the Earth Robotech Defenders, battling to save something they know next to nothing about. And soon, a new threat, the Invid, will arrive. And once this new force comes on the scene, there is no clear chance of victory. In this war of confusion and dislocation, the Robotech Masters are about to unfold a desperate new strategy.
My lords, we may have found Zora's battle fortress.
Good.
Furthermore, my lords, a routine scan of the fourth quadrant indicates a large discharge of protoculture mass.
There are two possibilities. Either the disciples of Zor have found the abandoned protoculture factory and have begun a new offensive against our Zentradi warriors, or the Invid have beaten us to the prize and now control production of protoculture.
I believe that is highly unlikely. All logic circuits suggest that the Invid have no knowledge of the whereabouts of Zor's battle fortress at this time.
Then we must assume that the Zentradi have indeed found the protoculture factory, ensuring a future for our robo-technology.
But only if they were able to capture the ship intact.
My only fear would be that Zor's disciples may have mastered the inner secrets of Robotech and were able to defeat Dolza's vast armada.
One ship against 4 million? Most unlikely, nearly impossible.
If they could invert the Robotech barrier system, an overload could possibly destroy Dolza's entire fleet.
In order to do that, Zor's disciples would have to know as much about that Robotech ship as we.
In any event, a display of energy of such magnitude would certainly have shown on our sensors. We must admit the destruction of 4 million Robotech vessels doesn't happen every day.
And without our knowing it.
That is quite true, Master. Nevertheless, it is also true that our sensors do indicate the disturbance of that magnitude.
System alert! Prepare at once for a hyperspace jump.
Our supply of protoculture is extremely low. We may not be able to use the phone system.
The order has been given. Obey without question. We will make the jump immediately.
Aboard the now quiet SDF-1, a lonely figure waits. He ponders a decision which will deeply affect Lisa's future and the future of all mankind.
Yes, who is it?
Captain Hayes reporting, sir. Lieutenant Commander Grant said you wanted to see me.
At ease, Lisa. I have called you here for a briefing on your new assignment.
I'm sorry, sir, but I can't take a new assignment.
And why not?
Sir, I've decided to resign. In my state of mind, I'm no good to myself or the service.
You're talking nonsense, Captain. You can't disregard your duty because of some stupid romance. You're just going to have to grow up because I need you now more than ever before.
You mean you knew?
I have eyes, haven't I? Of course I knew about you and Captain Hunter.
Oh, I feel like a perfect idiot. Of course my duty comes first, Admiral. What is the assignment?
Good. Construction on a new battlecruiser has just been completed, and I want you to command it.
My own command?
Because you're the most capable and experienced officer in the entire command, the choice was an obvious one. It's a long-term commitment, though.
I understand, sir. I accept the assignment.
Thank you, Captain.
Thank you, sir.
Step over here, Captain. I want you to see this.
Oh, what an incredible view!
Yes. Our Earth is a beautiful planet. It's sad to think that we'll have to be leaving it soon.
Leaving? What do you mean, sir?
That's what the new ship is for. The time has come for mankind to grow up and leave its cradle behind. To go forth and claim our place in outer space.
Sir?
That's our assignment, Captain, to follow the trail of the Robotech forces into outer space and to try to find their home planet. Mankind's survival depends upon us. The human race couldn't possibly survive another holocaust like the last one.
But our defense system has been vastly improved, and we were good enough to defeat the Zentradi, weren't we?
For the time being. But even as we speak, Captain, the Robotech forces are speeding back to their home world for reinforcements. And you can be sure that when they return, we'll be no match for them. Even our highly sophisticated defense systems would be useless in a warfare of Robotechnology. First destroyed, they'd return safely home. That is why I intend to make certain that the next battlefield will be on their home planet.
But where is it?
We'll find it, and we'll put an end to this war by destroying their capacity to make war. We leave tomorrow.
I'll be ready, sir.
Somewhere, in the recesses of another galaxy, the Robotech Masters attempt to resurrect a being in the likeness of Zor. Zor, who took to his death the secrets of protoculture, secrets still hidden aboard the rotting carcass of the SDF-1.
I think that the best plan is to completely educate another deprivation tank tissue so that by the time we get it to Earth, it'll appear a Micronian.
Why do you think this clone will be different than the others that have been generated and failed?
Such insolence! Have you forgotten the basic matrix generation process and our time requirement? We must begin programming the tissue now so that if there is a failure, we can try again with the remaining tissues. After all, there are only 14 remaining in the tank. And how many of us do you think will survive the trip to Earth? It is my judgment that we proceed.
All right, but one more thing. Why don't we check the matrix figures on the remaining protoculture?
But why? They've been rechecked. We don't even have enough to make the hyperspace jump to Earth's solar system.
If that's correct, then we have no choice but to proceed with your new plan.
So then, we begin the trip under impulse power and rely on the cell tissue to complete our mission.
Yes, because that is the only chance of regaining the control of the protoculture. After all, look at what is left of their culture. Observe and survey the remnants of their once great civilizations. We must have the protoculture furnace if it has not been destroyed. Then we will have what we need to control the entire universe. So, even if it takes 20 years and the last developing clone from our tank, we have no choice but to proceed. I can see no other solution. So, if there is nothing further...
Old Council is with you. We acknowledge your wisdom and appreciate the generosity of your support, Elder, and we want you to know that it is out of loyalty to you and our forefathers that we have decided thus.
We understand the importance this mission holds, not only for ourselves, but for all intelligent life.
Proceed with your plan, then, but know there can be no margin for error without grave consequences. The future of all cultures, including ours, is in your hands.
Final preparations are proceeding on schedule. We should have no problems meeting our launch window. If we are to avoid a second Robotech war, we must make peaceful contact with the Robotech Masters and establish a relationship of mutual cooperation. That is the mission of the SDF-3.
I want to take this opportunity to re-emphasize that the Robotech Expeditionary Force is intended as a diplomatic mission. The SDF-3 will be traveling to the homeworld of the Robotech Masters, the third moon of the planet Phantoma known as Tyro. The Masters themselves have not engaged in actual combat for nearly six generations. However, it is impossible to predict with certainty how they will react to our mission. For that reason, the SDF-3 is being outfitted with a considerable arsenal of Robotech weaponry. In the event that we are met with force, we shall be ready and able to defend ourselves. I must stress the fact that the departure of the expedition will not leave the Earth undefended. General Leonard and his staff have already begun rebuilding the Robotech defense forces. And as the planet is not presently threatened by any enemy, we feel confident that the Earth is in no danger.
If I may interrupt for a moment, I'm not as optimistic as the ambassador about the lack of an enemy threat. Mark my words, the departure of the SDF-3 and its weapon systems will leave the Earth hopelessly vulnerable to attack.
Gentlemen, please.
It's all very easy for him to say we're safe. When the attack comes, he'll be on the other side of the galaxy.
Frankly, I think you're a bit paranoid, General. What attack do you mean? By whom? Where?
For all we know, there could be a fleet of your fellows in Trotty out there just waiting for us to drop
off,
out.
General.
But gentlemen, you're guarding our defenses. Once the SDF leaves orbit, I won't be able to defend the Earth from a flock of pigeons.
I don't suppose you know much about Rick Hunter, do you?
No, sir.
You're a little young to remember the first Robotech War.
I know he's our most decorated hero.
That's right, they give you a medal if you're lucky enough to be in the right place at the right time.
Colonel Edwards, it sounds to me like you've got a bone to pick with him.
You bet I have, Benson. I'm going to do everything in my power to bring that flyboy down to Earth, and I'm expecting you to back me up.
We Zentradi were developed as an offshoot of robotechnology. We are the result of an experiment in biogenetic engineering, an experiment quite advanced for its time.
Are the Robotech Masters as physically big as your people were at one time?
No, surprisingly, they're about the same size as you.
So you supplied them with their muscle power?
You mean the Zentradi were just the brawns for someone else's brains? No wonder they seem so dumb.
They came about as close as you can come to blasting the Earth back into the Stone Age. That's how dumb they are. I suggest you keep your opinions to yourself from now on. We haven't the time to waste on them.
Excuse me, Flyboy. I thought this was supposed to be an open forum. Seems to me your Zentradi buddies are the only ones allowed to participate. And frankly, that makes me a little suspicious. For all we know, these space apes might still be working for the enemy.
I've heard about enough out of you, Captain.
Enough bickering, gentlemen. Please, this is supposed to be a diplomatic mission. It might be helpful if we practice some diplomacy amongst ourselves.
Oh, arguments are a waste of precious time and energy. Personally, I believe the problem of the Robotech Masters can be resolved through purely peaceful means, and I expect to make that my top priority.
That devious little Centrati has got the whole Supreme Council eating out of his hand. It's unbelievable. A diplomatic mission. If it's a diplomatic mission, then why are they arming that ship with every Robotech weapon system we've ever developed?
It's called gunboat diplomacy.
Well, stupidity's what I call it. It jeopardizes the very survival of this planet. Something stinks here, Commander, and it's not in the ventilation system.
All station chiefs, please report for final mission briefing.
20 light years away.
This new armada is the single largest fleet they have ever dared to send against us.
The more ships they employ, the greater our triumph.
Their armada will be destroyed and their spirit broken. Ah, here they come, like moths to the flame.
Is there no one among them who sees the stupidity of this?
I will summon our defense forces. Do not bother the rest of the fleet with this. Our own ships will be sufficient. Assign half our fleet to engage the enemy in space. The remainder will go down to the planet. Once there, they must retrieve the protoculture.
And so the alien strategy is set, a flanking operation to avoid the Earth fleet and to swoop down on a defenseless area near Monument City, an area they have determined contains the remains of the original battle fortress and hidden inside its reflex furnaces, the protoculture matrix they so desperately seek.
There lies our last hope for eternal life and the guarantee of perfect stability for millennia to come. This time we must let no one prevent us from obtaining the matrix. Yes. Our time has finally come. With the addition of the new protoculture to this, our last fertile matrix, we shall finally have the power we need to regenerate ourselves and our society for the rest of eternity.
Meanwhile, far, far away, a very different sort of mission has arrived above the third moon of Phantoma.
Whoever they are, they've landed near our mining colonies.
Look, Cabell! There must be hundreds of them! What will we do? With the Robotech Masters away, we're unable to strike back. Only the old and the sick remain on Tyrol.
They're transport vessels of some kind. They're unloading something. I'll try to get an energy fix.
Don't bother. Look at the monitor.
The transport vessels are returning to their fleet. Now, what could they have in mind?
Frankly, Cabell, I'm a lot more concerned about these monsters they've left behind.
They resemble machines, actually, not monsters.
Well, whatever they are, one of them just spotted our remote.
I am beginning to suspect who this invader is, and heaven help us if I'm right.
They're headed straight for the mining colony at Rylak. Shouldn't we warn the outpost there? I can make contact.
No, we mustn't give our visitors a clue to our whereabouts. The men at Rylak will have to fend for themselves. I'm afraid the schematics prove my suspicions correct. There is only one species capable of producing such a device.
The Invid?
Yes, the strategy is typical of them. The Invid often deploy mechanized fighting drones such as these to clear away resistance before they themselves descend to the planet's surface. The Flower of Life, that's what they've come for.
That must be it. They've come searching for the Flower of Life, the primary catalyst in the production of protoculture. But that plant hasn't been present in this system ever since the Robotech Masters left.
It was a Robotech Master named Zor that stole the flower from the Invid. It was only a matter of time before they came here looking for it.
What madness! They're ripping the whole planet apart looking for something they'll never find.
No one ever accused the Invid of being logical, only thorough. These machines are incredibly complex and essentially invulnerable to any direct attack.
Then what you are saying is that our cause is hopeless.
I'm not saying that at all, my boy. Be patient. Here is the cat-like drone we saw earlier. Like its two-legged counterpart, it is an inorganic, computer-driven device, incapable of independent action. Therefore, its functions must be controlled by an external, centralized power source of some kind. And that is its weak spot. That is the one flaw in the system, and it's up to us to take advantage of it.
Cabell, what are you talking about?
Is it not easier to attack one target than 1,000? If we find that power source and disable it, then all the dreaded machines of the Invid will collapse like so much scrap metal.
Do you think we could?
Anything is possible.
they bringing more prisoners in? These monsters must want us smothered alive.
Shh, calm down, they'll hear you.
You, invader, what do you want from us?
You know very well what I want. The Flower of Life. Tell me where it is.
Never!
You me a fool? Where is the Protoculture Factory? Tell me, you insignificant little world.
He speaks the truth, we know nothing. We're but simple old men. The Masters never told us of such things.
My friend, I believe you. Enforcer, reward these simpletons for their honesty. And watch fire!
Huh? Oh. It appears to be some kind of timing mechanism. What does it mean?
It means our doom.
It must be here somewhere. Scan the entire planet.
We have my language, but we registered no protoculture activity of any kind.
Congratulations, husband. Once again, you have impressed us all with your supreme stupidity.
I don't like your tone.
I told you the Robotech Masters were too clever to maintain the protoculture factory in their own backyard.
Silence, woman.
If you hadn't been so desperate to prove yourself a great warrior, we might have sent spies to find where they've taken you.
Are you forgetting who got us into this predicament in the first place? I'm not the one who fell under the spell of Zor and allowed him to steal our Flower of Life.
Must you keep harping on that? It happened a long time ago. Since then, I have evolved, while you've remained the spoiled child you always were.
Yes, you've evolved into a pathetic imitation of Zor's race.
Perhaps so, but that's preferable to being an incompetent, petty tyrant. I'm returning to Upterra. Goodbye.
Stop! I forbid you to go!
Don't provoke me, you spineless little anachronism!
Wait! Nevertheless, we will proceed with the attack. I have already ordered our transports and gunships to abandon their positions in the outlying sectors and mobilize over the Tyresian capital. If I am to be frustrated by this pathetic little planet, then my revenge will be swift and terrible!
My husband's ignorance and stubbornness are enough to drive me mad. He is in every way my intellectual and spiritual inferior, a de-evolutionized barbarian. And yet his will is strong. When I am with him, I feel his mind reaching out to me, trying to smother me. He is jealous of my evolutionary achievements and would pull me down to his level. That is why I have returned to Upterra, the homeworld of our civilization, in order to free my mind of his influence. Now I see the path I must take. No longer will I be subservient to the Regent. The time has come to act on my own. If the Invid Flower of Life is to be found, then I am the one who will find it. Not by blasting some insignificant little world into dust, but by tracking down the flagship of the Robotech Master Zor. I will go to Hadon 5 and activate the Sensor Nebula. No matter where Zor's ship may be, even though it lies beyond the farthest fringe of the cosmos, the Sensor Nebula will find it. Then at last, I will take the flower back from the thief who betrayed me. And woe to anyone who would stand in my way.